We begin tonight with the devastating loss of one of Network 10's own, Jock Zonfrillo. His family has confirmed that he passed away yesterday, aged 46. Jock's celebrated career took him from a 13-year-old dishwasher in Glasgow to running some of Australia's best restaurants, and then, of course, onto our screens as a judge on MasterChef. His wife and four children now facing an unimaginable future without him.
He was the sharp-suited, bead-carrying MasterChef host who could eat all day.
One or two ingredients under here that you must feature.
Jock Zonfrillo joined Melissa Leong and Andy Allen as new judges on the long-running show in 2019 and never looked back. Today's shock news has left the television and food communities devastated. 46-year-old Zonfrillo was preparing for a day of publicity commitments for the launch of the new season of MasterChef when he was found dead in his hotel room in Melbourne. Police say they're preparing a report for the coroner. The news was broken by his heartbroken wife Lauren from Italy, who said, "With completely shattered hearts and without knowing how we can possibly move through life without him, we are devastated to share that Jock passed away yesterday. So many words describe him, so many stories can be told, but at this time we're too overwhelmed to put them into words." And from close friend Jimmy Barnes, "Jock was like a brother to me and we made each other laugh and cry. My heart goes out to his family. I am speechless. Rest, my friend."
I'm just going to turn it on. I might plug it in.
As a mark of respect, new episodes of MasterChef will not air this week. Jock was born in Scotland in 1974 and found his passion for food early, working in kitchens when he was still a teenager. But as revealed in his memoir, Last Shot, he also found trouble.
We were smoking pot behind the bike sheds at 12. We were, you know, crumbling up ecstasy tablets and speed and taking them at school not long after that, and then smoking heroin at 15, 16 when I was an apprentice.
Michelin-starred chef Marco Pierre White took him under his wing, but he didn't kick heroin until he made a life-changing decision to move to Australia in 1999.
I ended up in a toilet in Heathrow Airport, taking a last shot of heroin before I got on a plane to emigrate to Australia. It was my last shot at sorting my shit out.
Once here, he became passionate about using native Australian ingredients in his cooking, starting the Arana Foundation to promote Indigenous food culture.
You know, visually, you just, you know, you step out of a car and go, there's nothing here. But actually, it's full of food. And it's also full of their tradition and their culture.
And then in 2019, his life changed when he joined MasterChef. Suddenly, he was making the dreams of others with a passion for food come true, while he found himself in a brand new world on red carpets, accepting prestigious awards alongside his co-stars.
Look, it's amazing to win an award, and especially in a room full of proper famouses.
Yeah. Pretty amazing. But the world that was most important to Jock was his family, wife Lauren and his four children.
How about this robot? Do you think we'll finish it? I feel as if I'm doing it on my own. Am I doing it on my own?
Yes.
And my family life is so important to me. I've got an amazing wife. I've got these amazing children who I'm super connected and close to. I've arrived at this moment in my life where I feel like I've won a gold medal.
Jock Zonfrillo was 46. Angela Bishop for 10 News First.